The ruling by the Constitutional Court followed a constitutional petition filed in 2017 by Wakiso Mira Growers and Dealers Association Limited, dragged the Attorney General accusing Parliament of enacting the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Control Act 2016 without the quorum and failure to conduct public hearings for all stakeholders who would be affected by the enactment of the legislation as provided for in the Constitution.
The Mira Association specifically challenging the criminalization of people who were in possession of cat or mira common language. So the ruling of the judgment of the Constitutional Court effectively makes null and void the entire act.
In a ruling made by Richard Buteira, the Deputy Chief Justice, Justice Stephen Musota, Justice Muzamiru Chibedi, Justice Irene Muliagonja, and Justice Monica Mgeni, and delivered to petitioner's lawyers Isaac Semakade, court established that there was no quorum in the House and the Deputy Speaker ignored concerns of lack of quorum, which were raised by three MPs, including Muwanga Chivumbi for Butambala County, Alice Alaso, and Ruth Nankabira. However, the ruling by the Constitutional Court attracted mixed reactions from MPs, who vowed to return the legislation, saying such a ruling is likely to increase drug abuse in Uganda.
The nullification of the act, an anti-narcotic act, it's unfortunate, but as a parliament, we don't get tired. We are very ready to bring the back the bill, and we consider it. We're going to mobilize heavily all members of parliament to be with us so that we can pass a bill.
We need to know of the nullification of the bill or the act that we passed in the 9th Parliament to do with the Narcotics and Psychotropic Substances Control Bill. This law was meant to mitigate the increasing occurrence of drug abuse, drug addiction, but today I'm told the Constitutional Court has nullified this law.
Robert Kasolo questioned the motive of the Constitutional Court quashing the legislation, arguing that on the day the bill was considered, no MP raised the quorum issue.
That day when we were passing that law, nobody raised the issue of quorum. And I am wondering what court based on to quash it to say there was no quorum. Because I was in attendance the day we passed it. Now the issue of quorum, I don't know how it was ascertained, but in most cases, quorum, you raise it and nobody raised it.
Legislators welcomed the ruling by the court, arguing that this gives chance to Parliament to always follow the rules and provisions in the Constitution while considering bills.
Of quorum shows unseriousness on the side of Parliament. So going forward, that is why with the leadership, the current leadership of Parliament, there is insistence on people coming in and vote on calling on
them. They control the consumption of drugs. It protects our society, it protects our children, it protects the wrongdoing, especially issues of discipline. The bill is going to assist us in preventing smuggling of dangerous chemicals and substances within our country.
In April 2015, President Museveni signed the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Control Act 2016 into law, criminalizing the possession of narcotic drugs and psychotropic substances, where any person in possession of any narcotic drug or psychotropic substance commits an offense and is liable on conviction to a fine of not less than 500 currency points or 3 times the market value of the drug, whichever is greater, or to imprisonment of not less than 10 years but not exceeding 25 years or both. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.